All right, President Biden's $1.9 trillion COVID relief package is now law, and it includes a historic provision for $5 billion in assistance to black farmers. The money will go toward paying off the debt of disadvantaged black farmers. It will also fund a racial equity commission in the USDA to address what critics say is long existing discrimination in the department. But Republican Senator Lindsey Graham has another name for this assistance, reparations.
Let me give you an example of something that really bothers me. In this bill, if you're a farmer, your loan will be forgiven up to 120% of your loan, not 100%, but 120% of your loan if you're socially disadvantaged, if you're African American, some other minority. But if you're a white person, if you're a white woman, no forgiveness. That's reparations. What has that got to do with COVID? God help us all if we don't check and balance them in 2022.
All right, with me now is John Boyd Jr. He's a fourth generation farmer and the founder and president of the National Black Farmers Association. So good to see you, John. So what was your reaction when you heard the words of Lindsey Graham, the senator?
Thank you for having me. It's very disheartening to listen to those comments from Senator Lindsey Graham. And I've lobbied him in Congress, both as a congressman and as a senator, about the discrimination that many black farmers faced, including myself. And Senator Lindsey Graham never spoke out against discrimination or anything that affected black farmers, where we were not participating in all of the federal programs, including subsidies or loans. And he never spoke out against it. He never used his megaphone to support black farmers. And he had 6,000 black farmers. We checked our membership list, 6,000 black farmers. And he's never once supported us. In South Carolina. Right. So he's never supported us, but he's used his megaphone quickly after we fought for 30 years to get relief in Congress to speak out against us and play the race card here, where he knows that we haven't been participating in the subsidy program, farm loans, all of these programs have been totally shut out. And he used this opportunity to play the race card here, Fred.
So this bill, this loan provision is intended to, and I'm quoting now, you know, address the historical discrimination against socially disadvantaged farmers and ranchers and address issues related to the coronavirus pandemic, according to text in that bill. And I know you have had issues with the agricultural secretary, Tom Vilsack. You've expressed your reservations about him. How comfortable are you that he is supportive of this provision, that it'll be policy implemented?
Well, I spoke to Secretary Vilsack yesterday. He called me late yesterday afternoon to congratulate me on the bill. And I spoke to him about swift implementation of this act that black farmers have been hurting. And we need, now that it's become law, I would like to also recognize the president for that. He needs to act swiftly to make sure that these farmers get the debt relief and also set up the commission and those things to make sure that black farmers get technical assistance and outreach, something that's been lacking at the United States Department of Agriculture for a very, very long time. So I'm hopeful that he's going to act and act swiftly based on yesterday's call.
And black farmers are great beneficiaries of this, but also Hispanic farmers, Native American farmers, Asian American farmers all can look forward to debt forgiveness, 120%. Also, another few billion will be dedicated to outreach and training. How do you see this making a significant difference or making an impact on you all's livelihood?
I think it's the most significant resolve for black farmers in this country since the Voting Rights Act. And also, I think what's important here too, Frederick, is to look at those senators who put out 10 amendments. So out of this $2 trillion resolve bill, they chose to pick on black farmers. 49 senators voted to pull that language or reduce the language so that it wouldn't help black farmers and farmers of color. So we're very disappointed in those persons, and one of them was Senator Lindsey Graham. So when people say that elections don't matter, they do, because I think if the shoe was on the other foot, farmers of color wouldn't have got this major victory.
Lindsey Graham was among those critics of this provision who said, what does this have to do with COVID? How did the pandemic impact you, hurt even further black farmers who were already feeling the pain?
Yes, black farmers were told that we had to destroy crops ready in order to get crop insurance. And when the restaurants closed up, many black farmers lost their contracts in the local communities. So we were struggling. Now, we were told that we didn't qualify for PPP resolve. All of these things, we didn't get emergency loans, farm operating loans. And that's what I think the American people don't understand. When the monies are out there, they never seem to find black farmers and farmers of color. And this isn't a new issue. I've been trying to get debt relief for black farmers for over 30 years, and it just made it into this bill. So it isn't something that was new. Mm-hmm. It's something that the pandemic really escalated for America's black farmers and farmers of color.
You answered my next question, which was, you've been at this for a really long time, and now after those many decades, you are now seeing some of the fruits of your labor, not just for yourself, but for thousands of black farmers, Asian American farmers, Hispanic and Native American. John Boyd Jr., thank you so much. Good to see you.
Thank you.